reminds me of Fatal Attraction.
I know.
I will not be ignored, Nick.
And it might be just like that. I don't know. It's so close to that title. Like, I can see myself mixing that up, really.
Welcome to Blerd Up, where we talk about all things movies, music, TV, and gaming with a Blerd twist. We're your hosts. I'm Killer Cam.
And I'm Moni.
And today we have kind of a rare find here. So every now and then, Netflix will put out a Lifetime-esque movie. And some of them have been really good. Others have not been so great. But we stumbled across the trailer for one that's set to drop. Is it next week?
Yeah, the 16th of July.
July 16th. Starring Nia Long and Omar Epps, called Fatal Affair. Reminds me of Fatal Attraction.
I know.
I will not be ignored, Nick.
And it might be just like that. I don't know. It's so close to that title. Like, I can see myself mixing that up, really, most of the time, basically.
Well, here's the thing. The only thing that drew me to this movie was the fact that Nia Long and Omar Epps are
right.
in it. So I was like, okay.
Hey, yo!
You don't like
yo.
This show? What's the matter? We don't like this show, man.
I'm sorry. Love Omar. He's right, though. The only thing that drew me to this movie was Omar Epps and Nia Long being in it. So, and they actually played together in a previous movie, too, In Too Deep. And I like their chemistry together. So
oh,
I'm
yeah, that's
hope,
right.
Yeah,
they were in another one together, too, weren't they?
I can't remember.
I want to say they were. I have to look. It was during that period of time where all the, like, African-American-centered movies were coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And, again, some of them were good, and some of them were like, what is this?
This could have been on my time.
Right.
This didn't need a theatrical release.
But this one actually looks interesting, so we figured, hey, why not? Let's give it a shot. You'll start to notice probably the last few videos we've done have been very Netflix heavy. It's because there's not a lot coming out right now, and Netflix is keeping us going with the original content. So shout out to Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go ahead and jump into this trailer. Before we do that, though, please make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date with all our reactions and lists that we're putting together. Again, if you see something about this movie or if you have a recommendation that you want us to try out on the channel, make sure you drop down in the comments and let us know.
Yeah.
All right, A Fatal Attraction, premiering on Netflix, July 16th. Let's go.
Let's go. I'm ready.
Mom, you did it. Your house.
I'm headed there now.
This is a big lifestyle change. You think it was a mistake leaving the city?
No.
The last movie I saw her in was 47 Meters Down,
mm-hmm.
Cage. She was in it for like 2 seconds.
2 seconds. Didn't do nothing at all to drive the plot.
David, hi. It's been a long time, huh?
20 years.
But she was a dirty girl in Dear White People.
Seems like you're living a dream.
I do have the perfect life. But you know, one day you wake up and a person sleeping next to you feels like a complete stranger.
That's why I'm single right now. Because you just wake up one day like, I'm tired of you.
Just get a chance.
That's how affairs are formed.
I can't, I'm sorry.
Girl, it's
Wait.
Too late.
What is he
don't
from?
Don't be trying to come home and hug me.
That's
now.
How you know somebody guilty, too. You're like, what you do?
Us? There is no us.
They pull in a Jordan Peele with the music, too.
They sure are.
Who is that guy?
David.
You see? Nope.
That was like a girlfriend's moment from the TV show Girlfriends.
Can't you see? We were meant to be together.
Everything he's done has all been to get to me.
Somebody self-centered.
Girl, he
doesn't
shut
up.
He might kill 12. Popping out looking like Michael Myers.
Okay, all right, hold on. I know this is on Netflix, and I know this is one of those Lifetime-y movies.
It looks good.
I'm here for it. I can't even remember the last movie I saw. Oh, Dracula 2000.
He
was the last movie I saw him as a like a villain.
Uh-huh.
But this is solely him as a villain, and I'm super excited for it because usually you don't see him as a villain in a movie. And so when an actor takes that turn, though.
Uh-huh.
Yo.
Okay. This is the thing about cheating that I don't understand, because you never know how crazy this other person may be. You shouldn't even open that door, sister.
Right. That's why you don't entertain it. No, don't text me. Don't call me. We're not going for drinks. We're not going for after work drinks.
Something must have happened in the trailer. It looks like she cut it off before. But something must have happened, unless he's just purely loco.
Well, I don't know. Because in the trailer, too, she was like, he set this all up to
get
be
to
with
her.
Yeah.
So I wonder what the other motivating factor might be.
Was there
be.
Something like way before? Like he set up to meet her in the first place again or something?
I'm
here for it.
Who is that guy, though, that's playing her husband?
His name is, I think I wrote it down here, Stephen Bishop. He actually did play in an episode, or a few episodes, maybe, of Girlfriends. He was Joan's boyfriend at the time. He was like a baseball player. But I've also seen him in other movies. I think another movie was Till Death Do Us Part. It was trash.
Again, hit or miss.
Yeah. But he's not a bad actor, though. He's actually a really good actor. So we'll see.
I like the little thing, though. They kind of took the cue from Jordan Peele, though, with Joe. All the things your man won't do, and how it started to skew it. So it's kind of like... she looks like she might be a little bit tougher than what we're normally used to seeing in these types of movies. So I'm excited to see that part as well.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch it.
I'm going to watch it too. And I hope it's good. Because the director, I think the guy who directed this also directed, his name is Peter Sullivan.
Mm-hmm.
He also directed another Netflix movie called Secret Obsession, which was...
I remember that one.
Yeah.
That one was, it had potential, but it didn't.
I was super excited wanting to watch that one. I was like, Secret Obsession, oh, yo, let's go. And I hit play, and I was like, this could have came on Lifetime. this didn't need a big old budget.
It did seem like this was a Lifetime movie. But again, they're either hit or miss with me, you know, so I'm going to give it a chance.
Me too. Definitely with Nia Long and Omar Epps, I'm in. Press July 16th?
Yeah.
First thing.
All right, that's Fatal Affair, July 16th on Netflix. And I'm curious, how many of you out there like to watch these kind of Lifetime-y? Because I'll admit, I have a bad habit of watching those. But again, they either hit or miss. But if you know of any other, I don't want to call them cheesy, but good Lifetime-y movies... from Netflix, please drop down in the comments to let us know, because we'll watch them. We'll watch them.
Especially we don't have nothing better to do right now. Yes.
All right, that was another episode of Blurred Up. We're your host again. I'm Killer Cam.
And I'm Moni.
And we will see you guys the next time around. Take care.
See you guys in the next one.